The use of spare track links as armor for tanks and other armored vehicles is a fairly common occurrence. Although this practice was pushed to the extreme during World War II in particular, even some more modern tanks can still be seen carrying spare links or track parts somewhere on the hull. Despite being a seemingly simple and reliable way to add additional protection to your tank as you prepare to go into combat, have you ever stopped to wonder just how effective it is? If so, you've come to the right place, because today we will be answering the question, are track links good or bad for survivability? I have no doubt that already some of you have made your way down to the comment section to tell me that of course tracks increase survivability of a vehicle. After all, adding more armor to something is going to make it harder for an enemy gun to penetrate, right? As with many things related to tanks, and ballistics in particular, the answer is somewhat complicated. The simple answer is yes, track armor increases the amount of material a shell will need to pass through in order to penetrate your tank, thus increasing the protection. However, you might be surprised to learn that despite that, tracks can actually help shells penetrate a tank's armor in some situations. I know that may sound crazy, but allow me to explain. Before we get into that though, let me take a brief but important tangent to discuss the basics of shell ballistics. Don't worry, we won't go too deep into this though, because otherwise we would be here for hours. The part we need to discuss to understand what is going on with track link armor is what occurs when a shell strikes an armor plate. Let's first look at what happens to an unangled plate. This scenario is fairly simple, as whether or not the shell penetrates through the armor comes down to factors like the armor thickness, armor makeup, range, shell design, and shell velocity. Upon hitting the plate, the shell will either be stopped by the armor or will have sufficient energy to pass through the armor and potentially cause damage to the inside of the vehicle. In a situation like this, the additional protection provided by track links will be greater than the armor alone. The same cannot be said for when you begin to angle that same plate of armor. Now, rather than a simple armor thickness versus penetration, the angle of the armor itself will cause the behavior of the shell to change. This adds in a plethora of new factors, especially in regards to the design of the shell, but for the purposes of this video, I'll try to keep it fairly simple. If you would like to see a more in-depth explanation of this though, be sure to let me know in the comments. Depending on how much you angled the armor plate, the shell will not only be forced to penetrate through more steel, as this diagram demonstrates, but it can also result in the shell's trajectory being altered, resulting in it ricocheting off the armor entirely. So how can track armor affect this? Unlike a tank's armor, which is normally made up of specially hardened steel, track links tend to be a softer material. Due to this, when a shell impacts an angled plate with a track link on top, the softer nature of the material can actually have a sort of pulling effect on the shell's trajectory, negating some of the armor's slope. With the angle lessened by this, the shell will then have to defeat less armor, or could even result in a penetration when it otherwise may have bounced harmlessly off the tank. You have likely heard this referred to as normalization from games like World of Tanks, and although it doesn't appear to be used in documentation, that term does a fairly good job at describing it. This effect can also be seen during trials of spaced armor plates. When testing one thicker plate compared to that thickness divided into two plates with a space in between them, the two spaced plates were found to be easily defeated due to the trajectory of the shell being altered by the outer plate, allowing it to penetrate the armor. Don't just take my word for it, here's a clip from Hilary Doyle discussing the topic regarding the German use of track armor.
In mid-44, the Germans actually did a research program on improvised armor, and they looked at concrete, they looked at various other things, timber and so forth, and they looked at using spare track plates, which was a thing that the troops were doing in the field. But as regards putting additional armor on the front, they found that putting track plates on the front of a vehicle actually increased the risk of your tank being penetrated. With concrete, they established a table that you had to put so much concrete on the front of a tank to give any additional protection that it definitely wasn't worth the increased weight of the vehicle. So in general, they were issuing bulletins to the guys not to be putting stuff on the front of the vehicle, that the normal armor was good enough for the purpose.
This is mirrored by testing done by the British, which showed that a Sherman with track links gained, on average, a ballistic value of 16 millimeters. Similar testing on the Churchill revealed much less reliable results, with some shells even managing to penetrate the vehicle at velocities below what was anticipated to defeat that armor. Reports from troops in the field also support the benefits track links provide, with two stories from the 21st Army Group attributing the survival of a Cromwell and Churchill from German 75mm anti-tank gun fire to the track links on their vehicles. Given both of these accounts and the widespread use of tracks as armor, the crews clearly had faith in them to add additional survivability to their tanks, even if that wasn't true in all cases. I should note that all of this we have discussed is primarily in regards to the use of more traditional armor-piercing ammunition. Since other ammunition types behave entirely differently, such as heat projectiles, the amount of added protection, or lack thereof, will obviously vary. Interestingly, track links do appear to be quite effective against HESH rounds, though, with testing by the British showing that they could defeat HESH from causing any internal damage to an armor plate. So to answer the question posed at the beginning of the video, are track links good or bad for survivability, we can say with absolute certainty that it depends on the situation. Jokes aside, generally speaking, they do provide some level of additional protection for the vehicle. Compared to other types of improvised armor, though, they are far from the best option, as the amount of weight they add compared to the added protection is quite low. The British report I mentioned earlier notes that the track links add 16mm of protection, but the weight is equivalent to 43mm of armor. Bear in mind, this weight to protection ratio will also depend on the thickness and material of the tracks being used, which can vary depending on the vehicle. Given these factors, it helps to explain why following the end of World War II, you see far less use of track links as armor, with better systems such as ERA and other types of armor packages being issued to improve protection. If you found this video interesting, consider checking out my previous video talking about the use of spaced armor by the Germans during World War II. I also plan to cover other ammunition and armor-related topics, so be sure to subscribe so you don't miss those. That's all I have for you today though, so thanks for watching, and to my ConelyFans for supporting my content, and I hope to see you all on my next video.